So many of you would have, if you're into electronics or anything, then you've probably got one of these multi-handed things, or third hands, with clips and that on them. Certainly the cheaper ones, you're a bit limited. The back bar on there, basically you've got a ball joint at each end, and it doesn't allow you to slide it along the bar to make it narrower. Sometimes that sort of stops you from bringing the crocodile clips closer together to align any parts you want to solder together, like if you wanted to solder two wires together. So I've been meaning to do something about it for a long time, and I sort of think about it, and then it gets forgotten, and I think about it again and it gets forgotten, and then I come across Darbin Orvar's channel, and she did a stand more or less from scratch, a wooden base with sort of pillars on there, and a light. I'll link to her video in the description. But well, this is my version. No, it's not pretty. It's not meant to be. It's meant to be an item of work. It's a tool, and as long as it works, I don't care what it looks like. What I've done is chopped the back bar in half and drilled a hole through. That's actually a spacer. It's actually a hexagonal spacer with a thread on the top, so that's screwed through there. And then there's pillars at the back which these slot into. I've actually got other holes on the front of the board there and a couple at the back. But these pillars can actually be moved into a front position if you prefer it, for whatever reason. But also there are other uses which I'll show you in a minute. Now the obvious advantage is that you can physically bring the crocodile clips closer together, and if you're worried about that movement, I'm intending to do something about it, something like a bush like this with a screw in the side, and that'll beef up the column so I can get an actual thread in there. But that's, I thought I'd just share this while I was sort of thinking about it. So yeah, you can actually get the crocodile clips parallel and side by side, which makes it easier to line things up rather than trying to get it at an angle in the teeth, which never always works. Obviously, if you're working on small boards, it's sometimes handy to have the clips closer together, and as you see, even with that slackness in the arms, that's quite sturdy. The only problem is when you actually got two separate bits to line up, then you can go to a bigger board where you can actually get it on each end. And one of the disadvantages is that you can't flip it on the bracket. You've got to actually take it off and flip it over, but I've never actually used the flip over. I've always taken it off the clips, and because I'm putting components in, putting it in upside down, soldering it, flipping it off, turning it the other way up to put more components in, usually in my hand sort of thing. When I unclip it, it's just this is easy to do it that way. So I can do without the Indian version. Then you can get to sort of ridiculous sizes where you don't want too much interference on a large board. I haven't got a piece of large circuit board, but this demonstrates the sort of idea, is you can get quite a large board in there, and if you're worried about the this flapping about, just take a short stub. Obviously you need something like a rubber stopper on the end, poke it in one of the front holes, and you can rest your board on it, and that keeps it a bit more firm for soldering. The other thing that Darbin featured, which I did like, although I actually use a desk lamp, is there's a rod at the back there which will be for a LED, you know, bright LED light or something like that. Might be better to, you know, sort of get it in better position. I've also thought about one of these gooseneck lamps you sort of see in sort of cars and that. You know, you can flex it about where you want, and it might be handy to get a point of light when you're trying to inspect something. The other thing I've done, the bracket that held the bar is not useless, because you can actually use that on another bar, yeah, on this lighting column bar, and another clip on the end. You can adjust it in and out, and you can have two clips holding the board and a third one holding a component possibly. So yeah, that's always been a bit of a problem when you're trying to work through some components. You just can't spread the leads to keep it in place, and yeah, you want something as a third hand to support it. And you know, I shall get a clip to the end of that at some point. So of course, not forgetting the magnifying glass, which I put on a longer pole, and I've always found it awkward over the back. Not that I use this a lot anyway, but you know, a better position for the magnifying glass is actually at the front, where you can position it where you want to. There's that. Now, I don't use the sponge, never have, so that makes a nice handy position for the solder, and yeah, it rolls off. As long as you put your solder from the underside, you can roll it off quite easily. I've got another soldering iron stand on this desk, but sometimes I take the third hand downstairs into the workshop, so it'd be handy for that. But even up here, when I'm actually doing the work on the thing, you know, on this stand, then yeah, the soldering iron will be right there at hand. But when I'm not using it, I'll put it in the main stand. So there you go. I'm not going to go into the mechanics of things on this, you know, the mechanics of the build. This is a just a sort of show and tell sort of type of thing. You know, I saw Darbin's and I thought I'd do this one for myself, and I thought, yeah, why not share the video and let people get other ideas from it, and you know, maybe Darbin might benefit from some ideas if she happens to see the video.